Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. Today's video, let us see the new announcement from Adobe about Adobe Experience Manager. Adobe announced their Adobe Experience Manager as a cloud service offering today. Let us see some details on that. Before going into that, let us see some of the current options and the challenges. The current options are AEM on-premise, means build the AEM architecture on local data centers. The second one is Adobe Managed Services, so called as AMS. So here build the AEM architecture on cloud and manage through Adobe. It will add lot of scaling and auto scaling, performance and options. So because it's managed and monitored by Adobe. So the third option is direct management through cloud. So here building the AEM architecture on cloud, either Amazon or Azure or any cloud provider, and directly managing it. So we can directly manage it. So let's see some of the current challenges. So now any of other now the like other option is like direct cloud AEM cloud option. So let's see like what does that mean. So now let's see some of the current challenges. So with the AEM setup, the first one is initial setup time is high. So it means more time to set up the environment initially. So we need to set up multiple instances like dev to let's say production. Environment setup is one thing, then like you are developing the custom code, configuration and all those things, obviously it will take more time. So AMS or like we discuss about the different option, current option in that AMS or the direct cloud, cloud options address this to some extent. So means by enabling the cloud servers, so you don't want to build the servers at least, but still need more effort to set up the AEM servers and the custom code. So the next one is the tedious patching slash upgrade process. This is one of the challenge with the AEM. The upgrade process require more time. So also it becomes tedious based on the level of customization. But Adobe did some like improvements like pattern detector to identify the upgrade changes, and also the backward compatible packages to reduce the effort, the immediate upgrade effort. But still like it will take more time. It is like for upgrade itself will take more time. So the next one is the scalability, the scaling vertically or horizontally, like with huge data. So it's another challenge. So the AMS or the cloud option address this little bit, but still it is a major challenge. The next one is the security. So security is another concern because we need to have either like the environment is exposed to some of the attacks, so we need to protect that. So that is one of the challenge, current challenge with the platform. The last one is the deployment. So deployment of code is another challenge. So we need more effort on that, managing the code from the development to the production. So the AMS cloud manager, AMS introduced a cloud manager called cloud manager component. So this address by enabling the CI/CD framework, means like they have the cloud manager CI/CD framework. So it will help you to automate the development to the deployment. Even you can automate the performance testing, even automate the security testing. So yeah, so but on-premise instances will have this issue again. Now AEM as a cloud first SaaS-like offering, so whatever they announced today, this will allow customers to receive the benefits from AEM quickly. So it will have the it will have less onboarding time and also like less setup time, so that you can quickly get the benefit. So also you can have like other benefits too, like maybe we can talk through that. So cloud service version has like in cloud service, the cloud service version whatever announced today, the AEM code is separated from the content and asset. What does that mean is like AEM will request the content and asset from a separate repository. So the repository, the code repository and the content slash asset repository is separated. So what is the benefit out of that? This will help to automatically scale vertically and horizontally and provide better performance, because you have separate repository, so the volume of data is not going to be a concern anymore. So also you can vertically or horizontally scale without putting much effort of moving this data or copying this data and all those things. So AEM will now, this cloud offering come up with some digital foundation blueprint. It is called as DFS. The DFS will make it much easier to get your new AEM instance up and running by leveraging pre-built features. Means it's a kind of template, you can say. You can build your instance out of that, so that it will give all the pre-built features. So it will save more time to you, so to build and to enable the instances. Okay, so let's see some of the benefits from this. So one is like, first benefit is always current. So means like a new experience, management capabilities are seamlessly validated and made accessible to your instance, AEM instance. It means like AEM is always in current version. So right now we have different versions, either in on-premise or like the AMS version. So the AEM is tagged to a version like 6.5 or like 6.4, 6.3, like different versions. So but in this SaaS or in the cloud service, so it will be always on the latest version. So this will avoid tedious this upgrade process. You don't want to do the upgrade. Whenever there is a new feature, it will be rolled out to our instance. So second one is the modular, scalable and global. Means it will scale as fast as the demand, based on our demand. Then also it will maintain high performance globally. So like with the architecture designed to auto scale within seconds, so we can quickly auto scale the instances or the environment. Then the next one is secure by default. So it will provides like a better security. So with implementing the industry recognized standards, so it will ensure the data and the content is private and protected. So maybe the next one is the performance resiliency. So it's built with the redundancy, and there is a proactive monitoring capabilities. So that like if there is any issue, like we can quickly fix it. Also, it will provide the high availability platform. So another one is grows with your business. Means it has a simple like a pricing model. So also it will provide the required metrics. So based on that, we can predict what is required, like what capacity is required for our platform. So based on our business growth. So overall, it looks to be a better option to be considered, as this enable a lot of features. So less time to market, better performance, security, and easy vertical and horizontal scaling. Also, it will provide better maintenance with less effort. So even like easy deployment, easy setup, and lot of benefits are there. Looks to be promising. Okay, maybe we can explore a little more in the upcoming videos. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.